Consonant, please.
Thank you, Chris. R.
Another one.
M.
Another one.
D.
A vowel.
A.
A consonant.
S.
A vowel.
I.
A vowel.
E.
A consonant.
N.
And a vowel, please.
And a final O.
And your 30 seconds starts now. Steve, what do you make of that?
Eight.
Chris?
Nine.
Okay. Well, that's the sort of standard we're looking at, isn't it? Steve, what's the eight?
Diamonds.
And the nine, Chris?
Randomise.
Steve, what did you say again?
Diamonds,
isn't it? One D. Diamonds.
Oh, sorry.
Oh, bad luck on that. Randomise is brilliant. It's to arrange things in an experimental procedure in a random fashion, as you might guess. Brilliant.
Very good. Well, no other nines, I don't imagine, but was there anything else worth looking at over there?
There's Romanised. If you put something into the Roman alphabet, you Romanise it, so that's an alternative. Romanised.
Okay. Yeah. Time for our first numbers round of this contest, and Steve, it's your pick of those numbers.
Can we have two large, four small, please?
Two large and four small for the first numbers of this quarterfinal. Thank you, Steve. So we have 8, 3, 10, 7, and the two large, 50 and 100. And the target, 573.
And as always, 30 seconds to reach that target. Five, seven, three. The target then, Chris. How close?
573.
Steve?
Just 570.
Okay. Let's hear that 573 then, please, Chris.
Right. 50 plus 7 is 57.
50 add 7 is 57.
Times 10 and plus 3.
Times 10, 570 add 3, 573. Lovely.
Steve's busily sitting there kicking himself at the moment. Chris is on 48. Steve on 5. They can put their feet up for a second or two at least. Phil Hammond's been our guest all week long in Dictionary Corner. Time for one final anecdote, Phil.
Yeah, well, most of the themes I've been dealing with this week have been about embarrassing problems, little lumps and bumps. So I thought I'd tell a story about what's embarrassed me recently. I went to Australia, home of Danny Minogue, and my niece, Kaya, she looks like a Baywatch model. She's fantastic, and she plays basketball for the Manly Women's Basketball Team, a finer collection of Australian women you just couldn't imagine. And they took me out clubbing. So you've got fat 43 pasty GP out clubbing. I was wearing this shirt to hide my moobs. And they took me to the trendiest night spot in Sydney. Now, the trouble is once you get over 40, you've only got one dance, haven't you? The only dance you have when you're over 40 is shaking the thumbs. There is no other dance. And I thought, I can't possibly go on the dance floor in this trendiest nightclub in Sydney with the Manly women's basketball team and do that. So I said to the barman, do you know any other dancers? I'm a bit stuck. And he spotted I was a pom. He said, oh yeah, there's this fantastic dance you've got to do. They'll love it. It's called Big Fish, Little Fish Cardboard Box. I'd never heard of it. And he says, quite simple, you go Big Fish, Little Fish Cardboard Box. Big Fish, Little Fish Cardboard Box. So I think, fine. He said, you haven't got much action going on below the waist, so this would just be the dance for you. You can do it anything you like. So I go up there and I take the floor. I do Big Fish, Little Fish Cardboard Box. Big Fish, Little Fish Cardboard Box. Clears the dance floor. People are standing there, so I'm completely mad. I think this must be some sort of strange sect or something. What have I done? I've really offended everyone. So I rush all the way home and I look it up on YouTube. Have you heard it?
Yep.
Bob the Builder.
Bob the Builder.
I've been standing in the trendiest nightclub in Australia, dancing to Bob the Builder, Big Fish, Little Fish, Cardboard Box. How humiliating is that? My niece is actually videoing it. There's probably a DVD up on YouTube. So embarrassment is an important thing. I've got your little present all the way back from Australia, Jeff. It's an embarrassing problems t-shirt. I think I got to wear every embarrassing problem you've ever had. It's a large, so this will probably work as a nightshirt for you. Every embarrassing problem you have, you can find on this website. It's a really good source of information, embarrassingproblems.com. And obviously I'll throw in a copy of my book as well for Christmas. But that's the thing about embarrassment. Deal with it. Don't be embarrassed. Tell your story. Learn from it. Move on. Lumps, bumps, embarrassing dances, it doesn't matter. Just talk about your embarrassment and you get rid of it. Thank you very much.
Brilliant. Thanks, Phil. Here's our first teaser of this quarterfinal. The words this time are cook a cop. Cook a cop. And the clue, change one letter and the dog becomes a bird. Change one letter and the dog becomes a bird. Change one letter and the dog becomes a bird. Cockapoo is the answer to our teaser. Susie, explain further, please.
It's a crossbreed of an American Cocker Spaniel and a poodle. And there's so many new words coming from breeding dogs in this way. There's Labradoodle and all sorts of things. But that's what a cockapoo is.
Oh, it's interesting, because I've got a friend who's just bred a bulldog and a shih tzu. Well,
yeah.
They've got a zoo dog, obviously. Steve has got 5 and Chris has got 48 at the moment. Chris, it's your choice of letters.
A consonant, please.
Thank you, Chris. J.
Another one.
B.
Vowel.
U.
A consonant.
F.
A consonant.
S.
A vowel.
E.
Another one.
Another E.
A consonant.
N.
And a consonant, please.
And a final D.
And here's the countdown clock. Steve, how many?
6.
And Chris?
6, too.
What's your 6, Chris?
Ensued.
And Steve?
Diffuse.
Ensued and diffuse. Diffuse, yeah.
Yes.
Good. 6 points apiece, then. Anything more than 6?
No. We've got sunbed.
Yes.
Okay. Here's our next letters round. And Steve, it's your pick.
Consonant, please, Rachel.
Thank you, Steve. T.
And another?
S.
A vowel.
A.
Another vowel.
O.
Another.
U.
Consonant.
R.
And another.
T.
A vowel.
O.
And a final consonant, please.
And a final X.
And your 30 seconds starts now. Chris, how many?
I'll try a 7.
Okay. Steve?
6.
Okay, what's the 6, Steve?
Trouts.
And the 7, Chris?
Outsaw.
Out.
Saw, S-O-A-R.
S-O-A-R, to outsaw, so something that a bird might do, for example. One might outsaw the other. Mm. Lots of out words in the dictionary. I'm not sure that's going to be one.
No.
It's not. No, not there, Chris, sorry.
Okay. So trouts is good for 6. Anything more than 6 over there?
There is just one of the six that we can find, Storax, S-T-O-R-A-X, a fragrant gum resin that you'll find in medicine, perfumery and incense.
I should have known that.
Just a couple of sixes around then, and Chris, it's your choice of letters.